Western Kentucky's a really talented team. They got a really talented basketball team, a lot of veterans. I would say probably easily the oldest team in our league as far as experience and time, and just we start with a couple graduate transfers and a redshirt junior transfer who would conceivably be a senior, starting another senior. So it's a veteran team in the starting lineup, and they make some tough plays when they see adversity. So they are talented. I'll start off by saying that. But the underlying factor right now is the Niners are playing their tails off, effort-wise. I'm really, really proud of what they're doing from an effort standpoint. And what I told them in the locker room after it's over with, I said, it's in here. It's in here. I know it's in here. Because we've seen some of these guys who aren't playing as well offensively do things in the past we know they're capable of. You know? And we're going to continue to find that. And we are going to find that. I'm convinced it's in that locker room. And we're going to keep driving until we pull it out of them. I love the way they emptied their buckets out there tonight. Everything they had, they never stopped playing until the horn went off. Now, we made mistakes. We had a couple turnovers. We didn't turn over much we did the other night. We missed some shots. You know, we don't normally miss, or we haven't in the past. But I'm really excited about how hard they're competing. And as long as they do that for us, we got to keep supporting them. And we're going to. We're going to keep pushing. We're going to keep driving. We're going to get back in here next week. We're going to work harder than we ever have. And we're going to go on the road and try to win a couple. That's our next step. And nobody epitomizes our level of effort more than this guy right here. Played his hard, and that's why we recruited him, because he just competes. Just plays really hard, hates to lose. He got three shots tonight and probably played as hard as anybody on the floor all night long, because that's not what it's about. It's not about him getting shots. It's about him playing hard for his team. And that's what we're continuing to instill in everybody. You know, they're playing for the people beside them, the people that are cheering for them. They're playing hard for each other. And that's what I'm most proud of. They're doing that now. Now we got to get to where we make. You know, we haven't been to the free throw line tonight. We're 21 for 22 for the free throw line. That's toughness. You know, that's production. Based on missed 9 the other night, came back tonight with 21 for 22. That's a step in the right direction. We're going to keep pulling those things out of these guys. We're going to emphasize positives with this team. And then at the end of the day, as we continue to grow, we're going to get better. We're going to improve. You know, it's a tough home stretch for us with the teams we got coming in here. But regardless, I told them the only thing I did not want to see tonight was a lack of toughness. That's what we talked about before the game. No matter what else, I want you to lay your heart out on the floor and let people watch you beat. That's all I want to see. And I thought they did that tonight.
Questions?
Coach, following the stat sheet, I think that effort really stands out on the defensive end. This is a team that we saw just 2 games ago put up 112. Tonight you hold them under 40% shooting the ball. Just talk about the defensive effort and what that meant to you guys to keep you in the game.
I don't know that we've guarded anybody better in the last 3 years than we guarded tonight. And a lot of that was we switched the defenses up, and, you know, try to keep them off balance a little bit. But in the first half, I thought, you know, they were 29% from the floor in the first half. I thought we really guarded well, but we weren't scoring the ball. We missed a lot of opportunities on the offensive end. And we tried to turn tempo up a little bit more in the second half with some pressure. So we tried to score in transition. That may be our answer, to try to score a little bit more in transition and not have to rely so much on scoring in the half court. But was really pleased with how hard they defended. We didn't allow as many low post touches. We didn't allow a whole lot of second shots in the first half. And we ended up getting out rebounded, and their two main rebounders bothered us some in the second half. But from a competition standpoint, I felt like we rebounded the ball well, you know, relatively speaking. You know, we're never going to be a great rebounding team, but thought we rebounded well. But really pleased what they did defensively. They bought in on a one-day preparation. You know, you got one day between Thursday and Saturday, one-day prep. So you have to really step in and guard some talented guys. And I thought the kids rose to the occasion defensively. Even though our offense wasn't going, our defense kept us in the game. And when's the last time you said that about our team? Our defense kept us in the game, and they did.
Could y'all say y'all got up some pretty good shots, just a lot of them really weren't falling. How do you keep confidence? How do you build confidence amongst your bench? The bench didn't put up any points tonight. How do you build confidence on your bench so you can keep throwing guys at the opponent?
That's a great question. Now, the thing I would say is we make sure we do a great job of tempering our shot selection. You know, but I thought we got some drives tonight. You know, Austin has some drives. He normally finishes. You know, I can remember Ryan Murphy catching one, passing up a good shot to Andrew in the corner for a wide open three. You know, there's some layups that went right around the rim that just sort of rolled off. And if we keep putting in what we're putting in right now from an effort standpoint, those things are going to continue to fall. That's what I told him. It's in the dressing room. I know it's in there. I've seen it too much. I've seen Austin finish those plays time after time after time. I've seen Austin, you know, Andrew jammed his thumb early, so that affected his shot a little bit, so he started driving the ball a little bit more. You know, I think John's got his game back in order, you know, what he's trying to do. He forced a couple toughs tonight, but as people tend to get, as they get confidence, he'll find them more. You know, we talked about playing with confidence. We talked about it the whole time. We got to get the ball around the rim to our bigs a little bit more. They got to finish. Milo's got to finish stronger than they. You know, Najee got to finish plays. Jalen's got to get more touches. You know, there's we got to continue to spread it out. And, you know, for them, I think the big thing about West Kentucky, you got to guard all five spots on the floor. You know, right now, we don't have to. They don't have to guard as many spots. On. They can really concentrate on JD and let the other guys take some shots. So those guys are going to have to raise up and make some shots, you know, for us to be more effective offensively.
Jalen, talk about that toughness that Coach mentioned, especially from your play tonight. Just looking at the stat sheet and watching them out there, Johnson and Colby, I mean, they did not look comfortable down there anytime they got a touch on the block, and a big part of that was your defense.
Yes, one thing that Coach Fancher harps on me is to bring a lot of hustle, to bring a lot of toughness to the team. I want to make sure no big that comes in here, anybody I guard, knows they're not going to get anything easy. And they've been doing pretty good a few of these games past, and it was just my mindset that I can do that good coming here. So that's what I'm
doing. One of the things you've been working on, too, has been making sure you're getting enough minutes and keeping your fouls down. And you got 32 minutes out there tonight, 32 really important minutes. Talk about how you've been working on that and how you can get better about that.
The coaches in this game will be a little later, like after practices. I've been working with some coaches individually about playing, using being verticals to keep my hands up, moving my feet more, and just not having the cheap ones, not bringing my hands down. That's something I really had to get used to, but I've been trying to do a better job of that to make sure that I can be active for my team.
Having you pulled down 12 big rebounds tonight, being such a large presence, is it frustrating for you not getting as many touches to be able to seem to be able to put some easy dunks in? What it looked like to me?
It's not frustrating. I believe in my guards. JD, he's a great point guard, has a great basketball IQ. And if he sees me down there, he gives it to me. If not, then you know I have to trust his judgment. Maybe that was something I didn't see. I like to get the ball down there more, but that's not the biggest thing to me. The biggest thing to me is doing my part to help the team success, because all the other stuff is going to come naturally. It doesn't matter how many touches I get. Eventually, I'm going to get it, whether it's off the boards, whether it's off the post pass.